and welcome back to my channel. How you all are doing? I hope you all are doing well. Today I will be doing a makeup tutorial, which will be a matte makeup tutorial, and this will be perfect for summer because if you are from a country where it's very humid and very hot outside, then your makeup tends to melt and your makeup tends to look chalky, oily. And if you put on some compact or something to just touch up, it looks cakey, and that's even worse. So I have faced all of those in my kind of experience. And if you have oily skin, then it's even more challenging because oily skin has a tendency to produce more sweat, produce more oil throughout the day, and yes, it's a struggle altogether. I have learned all these things along my way, so we'll be sharing that with you, how to prevent your face from sweating, prevent your makeup from looking oily, cakey, and all those stuff. So it's already a long introduction, I know. We'll not waste any more time, we'll jump into the video. So first I will start with icing my face. If you tend to sweat a lot, this will help you to prevent from sweating. And what you need to do, just need to take some ice cubes and need to put that into a piece of cloth which is clean, and you have to just dab that cloth onto your face like this. And you have to do it for 2 to 5 minutes. After that is done, you have to moisturize your face, and for moisturizer you take whatever suits your skin. I will be using a moisturizer from MAC. This is oil control lotion. If you have a oily skin, you can use something which controls oil throughout the day. After moisturizing your face, the next step will be priming. And for primer today, I will be using two products. One is this MAC setting spray, and the other one is Smashbox photo finish primer. This is also minimize pores. You don't have to use two primers because I do have a very oily skin and my skin produces a lot of oil during daytime. I prefer putting a setting spray first and then followed by a primer. And now I will use the photo finish primer from Smashbox. Now the next step is foundation, and for foundation as well we'll be taking two products. I'm so sorry guys, I'm so bad at choosing the right shade for me, and I feel like there is no right shade for me in the world because till now I have not got a right shade for my foundation. So I always mix and match two foundation, or sometimes a dark foundation with a light foundation, and kind of try to manage with this. You don't have to do all these two steps for primer and foundation. You can use one product which suits you and which is a perfect match for your skin. I don't have, unfortunately, so we'll be taking matte poreless foundation. This is from Maybelline. This is Fit Me. You can see this is a very yellow shade. I do have a yellow undertone, but this is way more yellow than my skin tone. So we'll be mixing that with Infallible Pro Matte Foundation from L'Oreal. And L'Oreal is, this one is 5105 Natural Beige, and this is 332 Golden Caramel. We'll mix two of them together. We'll mix that nicely and we'll just dot all over my face. And we'll use a beauty blender from Sigma to blend the foundation. Next, I will use some concealer, and for concealer today I will be taking Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer Multi-Use. This is 120 Light. We'll also use the concealer to highlight the high points of my face. all blended nicely. Now it's time to set the concealer with some loose powder, and for that I am taking Maybelline Fit Me Finishing Loose Powder. And now I will use my compact powder to set rest of my face. Now I will move on to eyeshadow, and for eyeshadow today I will be using Too Faced Plum Spring Dreams Cocktail Party Eyeshadow Palette. This has 7 matte shades and that will be enough for today's eyeshadow tutorial. I don't need more than that. We'll use the same brush like every day, P10 from Wet n Wild. Sorry if you can hear some music at the background. I am actually listening to some music because it's 1 o'clock at night. I will take this shade as a transition shade and we'll take the same brush, P10 from Wet n Wild. We'll take a blending brush, fluffy blending brush, which is from PAC 041, and blend a transition shade. We'll take this shade, which is a very dark brown kind of a shade. We'll use that for the outer corner. And now we'll take the same blending brush and blend the dark shade with the transition shade. Now I will use this shade for the inner half. I will use my finger. We'll take the shade and we'll apply that to the inner portion. Now for under eye, I will be taking this two color, I mean this one and this one, like this, and then I will apply that to the lower, very close to the lower lash band. We'll not bring that color till the inner corner. We'll keep a little bit space there to apply that light shade. Now we'll take the lighter shade, which I was using for the inner half, this one. We'll use an applicator like this and we'll apply that to here. Now we'll apply some eyeliner and we'll be taking Inglot gel eyeliner, and I'm using E06 from Sigma. This is a wing eyeliner brush, but today I will not draw a wing. I will just apply the eyeliner very close to the lash band. Now we'll take a pencil brush, this is from Sigma E30, and we'll just kind of smoke the eyeliner out. For contouring today, I will be using LA Girl Pro Contour Powder, and we'll use a brush from PAC. This is 247. For blush on today, I will be taking Flower Beauty Sweet Pea. This is one of my favorite blush on. Now I'll do my eyebrow a little bit because they are in a very bad shape and I don't want to put a lot of dimension into it. We'll just brush it and then we'll just apply. This is, by the way, I'm using L'Oreal Genius Kit. This is Brow Artist, and we'll just give some definition to this part where I have less hair. I mean, I plucked it out. And with the gel, I'll just set this part. I would have highlighted my brow bone before this step because I always forget to highlight my brow bone and then later I struggle and I just kind of repeat this step again. So no other option, I have to highlight my brow bone, and for that we'll be taking this shade from the eyeshadow palette. Yeah, I mean this one. We'll put some white kajal pencil to the waterline, and I really don't know how to pronounce this name, so we'll put a link in the description box. We'll apply some lipstick and we'll outline the lips first before putting lipstick. This is Kiko Milano 534. For lipstick today, I will be using Masaba by Nykaa. This is Killing Me Softly, and I really love the packaging. This looks like this. It's so pretty and it's made out of cardboard. I'm left with my mascara. Before that, we'll apply some setting spray because I don't use a waterproof mascara. So if you are using a waterproof mascara, you can use the setting spray at the end after your mascara, after everything is done. But as I don't use a waterproof mascara, this happens most of the time. To prevent that, you can take a tissue paper like this and then just do, so what I was saying, I will apply the setting spray first, then the mascara, because it's not waterproof, otherwise the mascara will fall here ... and it will be very difficult to remove. We'll be using the same setting spray from MAC to set my face. Mascara. I forgot to curl my lashes. Okay, it's okay. If you want, you can curl your lashes before putting mascara on. Today I forgot to curl my lashes as I'm not used to curl my lashes every day. I put my mascara like this only. So yeah. all these things to prevent sweating and to prevent my makeup from getting oily, cakey throughout the day. I hope this will be helpful for you. And please let me know in the comment section, was it helpful or not? Did you like it or not? And if you have any suggestion, any advice, any request, please mention that in the comment section. I would love to hear from you. Thank you so much once again for watching my video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please press that red subscribe button and also press the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notification every time I post. We'll see you soon in my next video. Till then, stay happy, stay healthy, and stay beautiful. Bye bye.